So take some time to let your body settle into whatever position it wants to be in. As much as possible, let yourself rest into the support underneath of you, whether that's a bed, a floor, a couch, a chair. For the next bit of time, you don't have to do anything. And then if there's any way you can make your body 5 to 10% more supported or at ease, take time to wiggle or cover that toe, tuck in the blanket, get the wrinkle out of the clothes that you can feel, whatever it might be. And then tune into the sounds that you hear. Let your awareness wander to the obvious sounds, the quiet sounds, the subtle sounds. And now feeling the body. So feeling the connection of your feet to what they're touching. If it's hard to feel the body, move it just a little bit so you can have that sense of friction that gives you the sensation a little bit stronger. Feel the connection of your legs to whatever they're touching. Hips and buttocks. Feel what your back is coming into contact with. Feel the connection of the arms to what they're touching. The hands, and the back of the head. And then drop into your intention. and saying your intention three times to yourself. Now tuning into your inner resource, that person, place, or being where you feel a sense of safety, connection, wholeness, ease. And however you first connect with it might be a visual, it might be a sensation, it might be a sound. See if you can then drop into the bodily experience of being with this inner resource. Where does that experience live in your body, and how does it live in your body? Is it warm or cool? Is it moving or still? Does it envelop your whole body, or is it kind of isolated in one or particular areas? Is it soft or hard? Letting yourself rest in the direct experience of your inner resource. That's always with you, whether you're with that person, whether you're in that place, this you have access to. This is yours. Now, as we go through a body scan, to see if you can stay connected to that inner resource, even inviting it to different body parts. So if it's like a warm glow, can you invite that glow into your right foot? If that feels like too much thinking, let that part go and simply work with awareness of the body part. Left foot. Right ankle. Left ankle. Right lower leg. Left lower leg, right knee, left knee, right thigh. left thigh. Right hip. Left hip. Whole pelvis. Belly. Low back, right ribs, left ribs, space between the ribs, chest, upper back, right shoulder blade, left shoulder blade, right shoulder, left shoulder, right upper arm, left upper arm, right elbow, left elbow, right forearm, left forearm, right wrist, left wrist, right hand, left hand, right hand, arm, and shoulder all together. Left hand, arm, and shoulder all together. Neck. Back of the head. Top of the head, forehead, right eye, left eye. Right ear. Left ear. Nose. Mouth. Whole face, whole head, whole body. Whole body all together. Whole body. Mouth, ears, nose, eyes, forehead, crown of the head, back of the head, neck, shoulders, upper arms, elbows, forearms, wrists, hands, hands, arms, and shoulders together. Chest. Upper back. Shoulder blades, ribs, space between the ribs. Belly. Low back. Pelvis. Hips. Thighs. Knees. Lower legs. Ankles. Feet. Whole body. Feel the whole body. The whole body, all together. Bring your attention to your breath. Feel the natural rhythm of the breath coming and going. We're going to work with the breath here, and as I offer some options, take them or leave them, with the breath, I want it to be really easy. So if it ever feels like it's straining or causing any sort of agitation, back off. So you can stay with this the whole time, watching the breath come and go as it naturally does. If you want to add some breath work, as you inhale, count to four, and as you exhale, count to four. So you're making the inhale and the exhale match. Your count, rhythm, pace. You're not necessarily trying to make the breath longer or shorter, but allowing them to even up. If this feels like the right rhythm for you, breathing in four, breathing out four, stay with it. If you wanted to try lengthening the exhale a bit, you'll stay with inhaling four, you'll exhale six. So just slowing that exhale down a little bit so it can go two more counts. Again, whatever count you're at, you can stay right there. So you can stay with four, inhaling four, exhaling six. Or we're going to lengthen the exhale one more time. So we'll stay with inhaling to four, now exhaling to eight. Listen to your nervous system if it says that's too much. Stick with 4-6 or 4-4. After your next exhale, whatever we're counting or not counting you're doing, let all that go. Just let yourself be breathed. Let the breath move how it wants to move. And touching back in with your inner resource. And as we go to work towards a challenge, if you feel like, again, sort of with the breath, if it feels like it's too much, take a break, go visit your inner resource, and come back whenever you want. You can also stay with your inner resource for the rest of the practice as well. So that in itself is a powerful practice. So we're going to start with a visualization of the challenge. So the thing that you want to get some clarity around. So bring that into your awareness. And if that thing, whether it was some challenge in a relationship or physical pain or anxiety, if that was going to walk into the room, that particular challenge, what would it look like? Would it be a creature, an animal? Would it be something in nature like a tornado or a rock or a volcano? Would it be a child? Or an adult? A person? An animal? And I'll also just say, so for some people, visualization isn't something that comes pretty natural. So if you're finding that this isn't resonating, you can also do this with physical sensations, which we're going to get to next. But you can work with this from a physical standpoint as well if the visualization's not working for you. So if you have the vision, the visualization, the image, just notice how it moves. Is it chaotic? Does it not want to come in? Is it rolling around? Is it yelling? Is it screaming? Is it quiet? Now imagine you can put this challenge, this image on stage, and you're just going to sit back in the audience as if it was showing you a play, a performance. And you get to sit back and observe it. Watching it move, watching it speak or not speak, watching it interact or not interact. You and the audience can be connected to your inner resource. And then we're going to ask this image three questions. It may give you an answer. It may decide it wants to talk. It may not. See if you cannot have any expectations, but just curiosity of what it might share with you. Silence is also a share. So from your place of safety in the audience, as you look at this image, ask it What does it need? And then the next question, what does this want? And then the last question, what action, if any, is this asking you to take in the world? And then see if there's anything else it wants to share beyond these three questions. Now tune into your body and see if you can feel the experience of healing this challenge or the opposite of this challenge. So if it's sadness, what would you, or if it's grief, what's the opposite of that? And it might not be joy. It could be contentment. It could be peace. So you find your words, and then if you could experience the opposite of that challenge, what would that feel like in the body? Invite in that opposite feeling for a few moments. And then go into feeling the challenge in your body now after you've had this conversation with it. How is it living now? How is it feeling? And tune into the direct experience of it. Where does it live? How does it live? Go back to the opposite. The feeling of this challenge being healed or resolved. Or transmuted. And go back to the challenge itself in the body. How it feels now. And now you're going to hold these two things together. So the challenge and the opposite of the challenge. Imagine or feel what it's like to hold them and feel them at the same time. Let that effort go. Come back to your inner resource. Just drop back in. And then bring into your awareness that moment of joy, bliss, a feeling of strong and independent and safe. So there's the awareness of joy, and then there's the awareness itself, the part that is observing and knows you're having this experience. See if you can feel awareness itself. How do you experience awareness? Go back into the direct experience of joy and bliss and safety. laughing and relaxing and going at your own pace. And then again, step into awareness itself. There's the joy. There's the awareness of the joy. And there's awareness of awareness. Feel awareness itself. And one more time, come back to the feeling of joy. Let yourself soak it in. And then as much access as you have to it right now, if your eyes are closed, see if you can open your eyes and stay connected to joy. And then close your eyes again, re-intensify it from the inside out, bringing up the images, the feelings, the sounds, the sights. Then you can try it a couple of times where you stay connected to the internal state and you open your eyes and start to take in the sights of your space, the sounds of your space. And then you can start to invite movements in. And so undirected, just whatever feels right to you, whether it's wiggling, rocking back and forth, giving yourself a hug. And when you feel like you've left that experience of, or that connection to bliss or joy, see if you can close your eyes, come back to stillness, reconnect to it, and then come back out. So a little pendulation here, going in and out, staying connected to that ananda. You can keep playing with this, keep exploring this, moving in and out. And when you're ready, you can come back up to a seat, but take your time.